Good afternoon. My name is Lee Massey. I'm Assistant Commissioner with FDLE. And on behalf of Commissioner Glass, I want to express our appreciation for you all showing up today. Obviously, we're here to discuss the arrest of Regina Hill. I'm going to give a brief overview of some of the information, and then I'm going to turn it over to Special Agent in Charge, John Vecchio. Mrs. Hill effectively betrayed the trust of her community by taking advantage of a 96-year-old elderly citizen, which is one of the most vulnerable in that community, a victim who was the last of her family in the area, was manipulated and lied to, her finances and personal information misused and abused for Hill's personal benefit. Obviously, extremely tragic. This investigation was very exhaustive, required countless hours of witness interviews, document analysis, which we all know is very time-consuming, and investigative methods on top of those to complete. I want to now turn this press conference over to Sac Vecchio, who's going to talk about the charges and then some of the details of the investigation. But before John comes up here, I do want to let you know the case is still active. We're still responding to inquiries about issues. So he's going to be limited on what he can answer, and I want to sort of lay that out to you guys before he comes up. But that being said, I'm going to turn it over to Sac Vecchio to give you some of the details. John?
Good afternoon. My name is John Vecchio. I'm the Special Agent in Charge for the FDLE Orlando Region. Today, FDLE arrested Orlando City Commissioner Regina Hill on the charges of 3 counts of exploitation of an elderly person, 1 count of scheme to defraud, 2 counts of fraudulent use of personal identification information, and 1 count of mortgage fraud greater than $100,000. Hill took advantage of one of the community's most vulnerable citizens and one of her constituents by obtaining and later using the victim's personal information and financial funds for her own benefit. This investigation began in February of 2023 when the Florida Attorney General's office contacted FDLE about a criminal complaint against Hill. The complaint alleged that Hill was taking advantage of an elderly resident who lived alone in a home that was in disrepair. Agents discovered that Hill used her influence over the victim to fraudulently obtain a power of attorney. From there, Hill criminally used the victim's personal information purchase a home in the victim's name. Hill repeatedly used the victim's finances to purchase rental cars, hotel stays, personal luxury items such as expensive bottles of perfume from high-end retailers, clothing, and paying her own personal bills. Hill moved into a vacant home that the victim had inherited from her family and then used the victim's personal finances to pay for renovations on that home, while the victim's primary residence where she lived remained in disrepair. Hill's crimes cost the victim more than $100,000. This was a complex investigation, involved a thorough review and analysis of several years of financial records. We located many witnesses, and we interviewed them, and we did that to identify the full extent and the evidence of the exploitation that had taken place over the years. I want to thank the FDLE agents who are behind me, the investigative team, as well as our partners at the Ninth Judicial Circuit and the Office of Statewide Prosecution for their dedication and countless hours of investigative work that resulted in this arrest. This case does remain active and ongoing.